Kyla Grant, you're very, very welcome.
It's a pleasure to be here.
That's a beautiful track. How lucky I must be. Mm. And you must be thinking that yourself.
I feel like that every day. Yeah. Every day.
Absolutely beautiful. I have to say that I am a very big fan of yours.
Well, I'm glad.
Yeah.
It would have been awful if you hadn't been.
We could have had problems, couldn't
we? There could have been problems, yeah.
But I must say, I have been a fan of yours for, a good 7-8 years. I like the songs.
Where were you before that?
Well, I won't say who I was following then, but you've been with me for 7 years.
Oh, well, so that's all right.
So that's great. But listen, the songs that you write are absolutely beautiful. Where do you get the inspiration for these songs? Because each and every song has their own. I know people say that Irish songs and Scottish songs have stories, but yours in particular have stories. And they're stories that you can cling on to and you never get bored to. Where do you get the inspiration for those songs?
It can come at any time, Richard, to be honest. I mean, I write travelling. For instance, one of the albums, it was about, 3 or 4 of the songs was written when I was travelling through Australia.
Right. And so things just come to you as you're travelling?
Sometimes 2 or 3 o'clock in the morning. Cottage in the Country, which of course is written a few years back now. Mm. I got out of bed at 2 o'clock in the morning with this idea flying around in my head.
Right. And you have to get it down on paper?
And I've got to get it down. So I lifted the guitar and by 2:30 I was back in bed again.
Fantastic.
And that's how they come.
What a great night's work.
It was. The songs find me. Rather than me go out looking for them. If I have to go looking for a song...
Now, I know that I watched the DVD, Home From Home, and I have to say that it really is the most beautiful DVD I've watched in a long, long time. It's so relaxing.
The songs is
great, beautiful songs.
It was very relaxing to film, actually. I mean, that's 2 or 3 years back now, that one was filmed.
And you worked with CMO Records?
I was with CMR.
Peter Cassidy?
For 10 years I was with
CMR.
Right,
and are they the people that did that DVD?
They actually done the DVD.
Well, they have to be congratulated.
It was Mick Bracken, actually, that filmed
Michael, who
turned out to be a good friend. But we had a lot of fun. It was done, Home From Home, of course, was because it was filmed half in Scotland and half in Ireland. And Ireland is home from home for me.
Now, Isla, you're absolutely massive in Ireland, Australia, Canada?
Canada, New Zealand.
New Zealand.
Massive in New Zealand.
But you're now starting to get very, very, very popular here in the UK as well.
Yes, and if I could only find more time to tour over in the UK, I think it would be. But it's, the tours are coming in all the time, Richard. I mean, we're just back from Canada. And, when you get told 2 months before that the tour's sold out, it's a lovely feeling.
Must
to
be a
go
great
over.
Feeling, yeah.
And we had a great tour. Now, we're home now. In September, we go away to New Zealand for 40 concerts over there. And they'll be all sold out. The last year they were all sold. So it's an end.
Does it excite you then to go on tour?
It excites me going back to see, I call them old friends, all my fans that meet us at the airport and travel. Some of them take their holidays when I'm over there and they just travel with us from.
And so the concerts then, are they quite distances away from each other?
Some of them can be.
You know, like you travel from Manchester, London, wouldn't seem a very long time.
No, it's nothing.
But
that's
in Canada and America and places like that, are they very long periods?
Canada wasn't too bad this time. We flew into Ontario and we done concerts all the way through the Ottawa Valley, which I must say, anyone that wants to go to Canada must go to the Ottawa Valley. It's beautiful. Then we went from there to Quebec, from there to Nova Scotia, and from Nova Scotia we went to Newfoundland. We finished and we had 16, I think, in Newfoundland. And it was an easy tour this time, except for the ferry that we had to get from Nova Scotia over to Newfoundland. We were told it was a 5-hour journey, and we sat on the ferry for 4.5 hours without it moving. They said they couldn't get the door shut at the back. I says, well,
oh,
we would prefer it if it was.
Right.
And then it took 7 hours after that. So apart from that, it was an easy tour.
What I like about a lot of your live shows is that you use the very best in musicians.
I wouldn't have it any other way.
Absolutely superb musicians. They
wouldn't
really
have
are.
It any other way.
Now, that must be difficult to find top quality musicians.
They find me.
And keep them.
They find me. My steel player's been with me for 9 years.
Right.
Al, of course, plays bass on stage with me. And my musical director was for many years musical director for Van Morrison. And he found me again. And I actually phoned him to ask if he knew of a lead guitarist, because my own guitarist was going to go out on his own and do a duo thing. So I phoned Johnny up and I said, would you know of anyone that might? He says, well, what's wrong with me? So it's been absolutely fantastic, and it's a real family.
It is, and you can feel that on, you can feel that when you're watching your concerts and things. Any plans for the UK then over the next few months?
I'm touring the UK, a very small one in September.
Okay.
And I just don't have all the dates with me, but we're...
Where are you starting?
We start, I think we start up in Scotland, I think.
Okay.
And we move right down, where are we down this area? I don't think we're actually in this area at all. That's what I would really like to do, is to get into this area. But it'll be well advertised. It's just I haven't had time to sit down really and see where
we can look forward to a UK tour.
And then straight after that, I'm off to New Zealand.
Right. Now, you have a new album out at the moment, haven't you?
There's Moving On's out, and we were delighted because we got word to say that the album went straight into number 3 in the national charts in New Zealand. And well, Sony Music are taking the next one.
Brilliant.
And it was Universal that had the last one. But there's another new one just been recorded.
These big record companies are now taking you on, it must be great news altogether.
Well, it's nice when I don't need to knock on their door, Richard. They're phoning me up, so it's very, very nice.
Isla, do you have a website that people can log on to
information? I do indeed. It's just www.islagrant.net.
Okay. Well, listen, Isla, I know that you've come all the way from Scotland to see us today, and I can't thank you enough indeed. We're so proud that you're here with us today. Thank you very much indeed.
It's been absolutely a wonderful
pleasure.
May
I wish you a safe journey home, and please keep in touch with us. We look forward to seeing you again
soon. We will do, and hopefully we'll be down here and you can come to one of the shows down in this area.
Thank you very much. Isla Grant, thank you very much indeed.
Thanks so much, Richard.